about what price is doing, because, well, the Indian demand is weaker than it was. We had massive levels of de-hedging in 2013, which provided price support. That's not there now. And so the market is a little exposed on the downside in terms of silver. I mean, silver is always more volatile than gold, but, you know, there are these factors on the demand side, these sort of price-sensitive factors, because industrial demand is very strong and can't respond. You know, you can't suddenly buy and make 10 more cars because the price has fallen. It's not how it works. Whereas from the bond market, the coins, you know, this is really quite important. We're thinking about the price action now and for next year. Well, this matters tremendously. And so some of these things have been covered. So, you know, you've had, as I said, the import regime for gold has been a factor. There is that huge preference from a silver point of view in India for physical silver. And of course, from a price point, it's very attractive as well. And then, again, another way to look at the same data. And again, you can see it's a massive increase in imports. And yes, it's small bit from 20th of July, but again, a bit of a pickup. So overall, it's not a bad picture. But again, you have to think about, as I've said in the title, the gold regime, the import regime has helped, but prices remaining weak. You know, we start to think about price expectations, and that is key going forward. What does the Indian investor think? You know, are they going to liquidate? Do they think that the prices are low and they should get in now? If they think prices will remain flat, well, maybe they should just wait. If they're going to wait, well, this is also another concern for the silver price as well. And then, just to really bring you back to the overall picture of what we saw, and so, you know, as I said, from a physical investment point of view, this is probably the most price-sensitive component on the whole silver S&D. Whereas with gold, it was dominated by jewelry was the largest component, and the bulk of that was emerging markets. So the bulk of, and also physical investment, was mainly emerging market for gold. So most gold demand is price sensitive, and therefore can react one way or the other. Silver, it's completely different. Industrials not, photography is not. Silverware, to an extent, but given that, as I said, for jewelry, the largest market is the US, but that's not very price sensitive either, compared to what, you know, it's like for gold. And so you've really got one component. And so you do have that risk. If prices do weaken, the amount of demand that can come in quickly, potentially, is a little limited. Unless, of course, one has the institutional investors coming in as well to back it up. And so it can be exposed on the downside. And just to be before I get to the gold, before the price forecast, this is just the gold silver ratio that some people do trade, and this has weakened again. You know, we think that this year and next that ratio will start to fall a little bit. So in other words, although silver will weaken, as I come to this slide, we think it won't weaken as much as in percentage terms as gold. And that's partly because as industrial demand continues to recover and strengthen, investors will just a little bit buy into that argument, and they may well be more disposed to silver than gold in terms of its core fundamentals. So that's our outlook. It's not the most bullish outlook for prices you're ever going to see, but that's what we think is a short term. And as I said, if I was to crystal ball gaze further out, we do think prices will gradually start to improve, but perhaps not the runaway that we saw of the past 10 years. So after that whirlwind through two markets, any more questions, happy to take them as well. Apart from you, because you're not going to be. Yes, sir.
But again, silver, it's generally a byproduct. So what are the metals which are mined, and what component comes into the silver, which are the major metals, like the copper?
Yeah, I mean, only about 30% is primary, and the rest is largely, I think, you know, it's copper, it's lead, zinc, and then there's some byproduct gold as well. And so what you've seen from a mining point of view is the gold mining until recently has done very well. So the silver as a byproduct has also done very, very well. But now, again, you do for the price, those based on the prices, and so that could be a risk. So even on the mining side, you know, even if silver by itself weakens, then the response from miners can also be limited as well. So I think that's again another risk. You don't have the supply demand balance overall can't react in the short term to price action in the same way that the gold can. Any more questions? Sorry, yes.
Assuming that I have a positive bias towards gold prices, what would you recommend to buying like companies like Barrick Gold or going for physical investments? How would you play?
I mean, that's a tough one. I think what you're seeing is, the mining companies have, we produce a 5-year forecast for gold and other metals, and we were surprised that the forecast at the beginning of the year, we've had to actually increase our mine production outlook for this year and next year, rather than having a decline, a plateauing. And that's because the mining companies have been very successful, A, cutting costs, like I mentioned, and B, the high grading. And so they've been able to do that. And I think Barrick is an example, it has some reasonable, head office cuts in its staff. So they're all having to address this. And so I think the mining companies have been very aggressive from that point of view by getting their house in order. But again, the other point I made is that you've also had this, part of this cost reduction is the cut in exploration spending. And so that doesn't affect me today as a miner. It affects me 5 to 10 years out. So I think that could be a risk. That's about the closest you're going to get to me recommending one or the other.
Just one more question. Do you have any idea about the stripping ratio of all these mining companies?
I don't, but I know someone who can help you. So again, give me a call afterwards and my mining colleagues will answer these questions very, very easily.
Okay. Any more questions? So, thank you, Philip, for such an interesting
thank you all for coming here. It's always remember to make it a nice success and hope to see you.